Welcome to the Heal Your Hunger Show, where we get to the heart of why you overeat and how to stop. If you struggle with food and weight like I did, welcome home. Welcome to the Heal Your Hunger Show. So happy to have you here. It is a great day to be alive. And I have a short and sweet message for you today, which I'm so excited to talk about. But before I do that, I just want to say, if you have been here before, welcome back. If you have not been here before, welcome. So glad that you found the Heal Your Hunger Show. Now, this show is based on my 32 years, can't believe it's been that long, 32 years of experience of having overcome my own problem with emotional eating. I was 50 pounds overweight at one time, and also the incredible privilege I've had over these many decades to help other women overcome emotional eating. It's been an incredible journey. I've learned so much in my research, and there's a way out. You know, there's a way by which you can lose the weight and keep it off without ever having to go on another diet or join an impossible exercise program. So that's what we do here at Heal Your Hunger. We talk about the underlying causes of emotional eating, which is usually the hidden problem, okay? We're always chasing after the next diet, the next pill or potion, or trying to understand our bodies and, you know, ketones and all the stuff we do without ever realizing that our emotional connection to food is what's causing our downfall, our self-sabotage. And that has to be addressed. And that's what we do with Heal Your Hunger. Now, I also want to say, if you have not joined us yet in the Secret Sauce group, definitely hop on over on Facebook and type in the Secret Sauce to End Emotional Eating, and you'll find us and join us there, because that's where I record these podcasts. I do them live in the Secret Sauce group first, so everybody in that group gets to have access to this right hot off the press as it's happening, actually. And also, I have guest speakers in there, and we just have great conversations about life, about emotions, about, you know, those things that just get the best of us and how to address those problems. So join us, type in Secret Sauce to End Emotional Eating. And lastly, if you're not sure if you're an emotional eater, if you're like, what is this about? Surely I can't be an emotional eater. I don't binge, or I don't, you know, I'm not overweight or whatever. Guess what? You can still be an emotional eater, but take the quiz and find out. So go to healyourhunger.com and take the free quiz. Are you an emotional eater or a food addict or somewhere in between? It's free. You'll get your results right away, and then you'll get directions on what to do about it. So on with the show. So today's topic is all about enjoying summer and wearing that bathing suit. And I am recording this in my bathing suit that I just put on because I'm headed to the lake. I'm here in Maine, and my sister has rented a cottage on Sebago Lake. If anybody knows Maine, they might know Sebago Lake. And I'm so excited to go out there with my guy, and we're going to go on a speedboat, which is my favorite thing because I love to go fast, and swim and spend the night and just have a beautiful time. So of course, I have to put on my bathing suit. It's the first time wearing my bathing suit this summer, and it got me thinking that maybe this was a good message for you. If you struggle with food and weight, I understand the bathing suit is an issue, okay? It's got some juice there, right? Because we don't like wearing bathing suits when we're not loving our bodies. And I have to tell you that even though I'm in a thin body now, I still have fat head. And if you know my work, you know I talk about fat head, which is, you know, our perception of our weight in between our ears is often wrong. So even though I know I'm not fat, and I don't even think I'm fat, and generally, you know, my mind is caught up to the size of my body, I will say that putting a bathing suit on, especially a bikini — you can't see the whole thing here, but this is a bikini top — for my whole life, I did not wear a bikini because I didn't like my stomach, and I used to have a big roll on my stomach, and I still have a roll. Okay. It's anatomically how I'm made. I have a roll on my stomach no matter what size I am. It was bigger when I was 50 pounds overweight, of course, but it's still there and I can still scrunch it up in my hands. I just no longer want to cut it off like I used to. But I used to wear a full bathing suit, a one piece, because it covered up my stomach. But in the past few years, I have gotten a little more daring and I've purchased a few bikinis. And so literally it's only been a couple of years that I've worn a bikini, and it's a little bit of a deal with me because I don't have a flat stomach and I have cellulite, and I, you know, right now I'm not that fit because I stopped doing my bar class that I used to do before COVID. So since, you know, COVID, I kind of let that go. I could do it at home, but I just never have the motivation to do it. So I'm a little flabby. It's like my fit, strong body has gotten a little fluffy. So when I put the bathing suit on, you know, a little bit of fat comes out here and there and my butt's bigger than I want it to be. And it just made me think, I got to talk to you guys about this because I get it. Even though I'm in a thin body now, which I'm so grateful for, on account of addressing emotional eating, only way to go if you want to lose weight and keep it off. But, you know, I still have some issues around my body and my weight, and I have a little bit of like, you know, I don't like how I look in this bathing suit 100%. And I, you know, talk to myself. So I have those negative thoughts, and then I talk back to those negative thoughts. And this is what I want to encourage you to do, is talk back to those negative thoughts. And the bottom line is that I look fine, you know, and you look fine in your bathing suit. And I really want to encourage you to talk back to those negative thoughts and do it anyway. Okay. Put that bathing suit on anyway, in spite of your head and how loud it gets with the thought of going out and being seen in public in a bathing suit. I talk to women every single day who are like, I don't want to be seen. I don't want to be seen. I don't want to go out to the pool. I don't want to go to the beach because I don't want to put a bathing suit on. And I just, you know, I get that. And I get the pain of being overweight. I get the pain of hating your body and being really upset with yourself and how much weight you've gained and the weight you've gained during COVID that you didn't plan on gaining. You know, I know all too well how deep that pain goes because it's awful. I mean, it's, I know how dark it can be when we've gained weight and we feel really bad about ourselves. It's a pain like no other. And honestly, that's what motivates me to do what I do with Heal Your Hunger. The pain of being overweight and being out of control of food is what drives me on a daily basis to get this Heal Your Hunger message out. Okay. So even though I'm in a thin body, I have not forgotten that pain. That's what drives me because I don't want you to feel that pain. I don't want you to live and muddle through life, you know, really not living because of food and your shame around weight. So today's message is get out there, put that bathing suit on, and enjoy the summertime. I'm going to go to the lake. I'm not going to care about how I look. Guess what? Nobody else cares. Nobody else cares. So when we think that everybody's looking at us, when we think that everybody's judging, they're not. And even if somebody is, it's like for a split second because there's other things to think about. So somebody might even think, oh, she's gained weight. Guess what? They're on to something else between, you know, before 10 seconds is up. It doesn't matter. And most people don't know. They don't care. They're not judging. And I don't want you to, okay? I don't want you judging yourself and keeping yourself inside or in, you know, clothes because you're feeling ashamed about your weight. So I'm going to go out to the lake. I'm going to swim with my nieces. I'm going to dive into the water. I'm going to get out of the water. I'm going to get into that boat. You know, my roll might be kind of like showing. I do, I have a roll. You know, and nobody gives a rat's ass. Okay. And so I'm just here to encourage you to stop hiding out. No matter what your weight is, you are beautiful. You are beautiful and you deserve to have fun this summer. And so when your head gets really noisy and it's like, you don't deserve to have fun, you don't deserve to be in a bathing suit, what are other people going to think of me? I'm so embarrassed. I've gained weight. Guess what? I think everybody in this country has gained weight during COVID practically, you know? I mean, finally people are figuring out what emotional eating is because of COVID. Like they're like, oh my God, you know, I'm eating all the time. I'm eating when I normally don't eat. So I have friends who are thin, but have gained weight because they're finally catching on to the idea that emotional eating is a thing. So bottom line is nobody cares. Nobody's thinking about you. Mark Twain said, you wouldn't be nearly so concerned about what other people think of you if you realize how seldom they do. And ain't that the truth? Like, they're not thinking about you. They're thinking about their own roles, not yours. So put that suit on, put it on, wear it proudly, you know, just let your body be, let it be, give it a break, you know, stop saying mean things about it. Love it, love it, enjoy it. You know, it's strong. It can take you places. It can take you swimming. You know, it can just relax and have fun and just, you know, just work on loving your body today and just accepting it the way it is. Nobody is thinking about you, even though you think they are. And, you know, the thoughts you think about yourself, please talk back to those thoughts and say, you know what? I'm beautiful. My body is what it is right now. I'm just going to enjoy myself. Just talk back to those thoughts. And, you know, they can just tell them, you know, thank you for sharing. I'm going to do this anyway. And sometimes I have to do that. I have to just say to my noisy head, thanks for sharing that. I'm going to go swimming anyway. And that's what I want for you. So this is a short and sweet message to enjoy your summer and don't hold yourself back just because you're not happy with your weight. And guess what? If you listen to my show a few shows ago, I talked about the fact that, you know, when you're an emotional eater, you hate your weight no matter what your weight is. So, I mean, if you heard me talking about my roles, for God's sakes, you know, they're not what they used to be. So I better love on them, you know, because I hear women all the time say, I wish I were the weight I used to hate. You know, I wish I were that weight because I was much thinner then, but I didn't think I was. So, you know, our heads, you know, are fettered with the fat head syndrome. And so we're never happy with our weight. So don't wait to get out there and put that suit on and enjoy the summertime. Just don't wait because your head really should not be considered. You know, don't listen to your head. Get out there, enjoy yourself, enjoy your family. Nobody cares what your size is. And of course, you know, emotional eating has to be addressed. So if you want to be in a thinner body and you want to have, you know, weight loss success, of course, addressing emotional eating is the key. That's the way to go. And I'm certainly here to support you in that. But in the meantime, do not postpone your life. Do not postpone your life. Today is the day to enjoy the summer and really have fun. So please, I hope you will. Please post below. Those of you who are watching on Facebook, please post and tell me what you're doing this summer to throw caution to the wind and enjoy yourself. Okay? Thank you so much.
If you enjoyed this podcast and want to get free support, insider health info, exclusive invites to events, and more, visit healyourhunger.com.